This is the Tech Podcast Network. If it's tech, it's here.
You know, medication compliance is one of the biggest issues we have in primary care, and you know how hard it is to get patients and help them to remember taking their meds. We got a great tool here to show you how that works.
Sponsored by Callisto.fm. Do you produce shows for the internet? Do you really know if anyone is watching or listening? Find out soon at Callisto.fm/beta to sign up and be the first to find out what happens after the download.
Hi, Jamie Davis, the pod medic from The Nursing Show and Medicast. I'm here with the Tech Podcast Network friends, and I am checking out the health-related stuff here at CES. LifeStation has a fantastic tool that helps you keep your patients on track with medication compliance. David from LifeStation, this is an amazing tool. Can you just kind of go through some of the features here that somebody can use to, whether you're an individual or a healthcare professional, to help somebody stay on track with their meds?
Absolutely. As you see here from the demonstration, say it's noon on a Tuesday and it's time for me to take my medication. This compartment will start to blink, and all I would have to do is simply open the compartment, take out my medicine, and take it. Now, say I haven't taken my medicine. After 30 minutes, the unit will start to beep. After a full hour, if I still haven't taken my medication, then it'll begin to notify both me and my caregivers. So I would get an automated phone call. My caregivers could get an automated... That's the beep. My caregivers would get an automated text message or email letting them know that I haven't taken my medication. As well, everything is web-based. So my caregivers throughout the day, say you're worrying about mom while you're at work, can log in and view real-time compliance reports, what time they took their medicine, have they taken their medicine. They can see a scorecard on their compliance based on the last few weeks or month and receive monthly reports. As well, it's very easy to make schedule changes. When it's time to go to the doctor, you can bring the compliance report with them. Refilling is very simple. Most pharmacies are comfortable preparing a blister pack. If you have someone who's a little bit difficult maintaining their compliance, if someone tries to turn off the equipment or tries to kind of dump out the pill box, it'll notify the caregivers. It'll immediately notify them that the wrong medication may have been consumed or that there may have been some tampering with the device itself.
What a great tool. Now, you say connected and web-based. How is it? Is it Wi-Fi? Is it an Ethernet connection? How does it connect to the web?
Well, it has GSM technology, so it has a built-in SIM card. So what's nice about that is it really makes it mobile. So if you have a snowbird who's traveling to Texas for the winter, or someone who's going on vacation for a few weeks, they can actually bring it with them. It has a backup battery that'll last for about a day, so if you do lose power, it'll still function. And it's as simple as just unplugging it and taking it with you.
Well, we're going to go ahead and check in a few minutes on the availability and price points on this, but we do have to check in with one of our sponsors right now.
You know, if you're a digital content creator, creating audio content or video content that you're distributing across the web, it's pretty easy to get the number of downloads that occur. What's not easy at all is to figure out how people are interacting with your content. How far into the clip do they watch? Do they rewind? Do they skip over certain parts? There's a new product that's going to be in beta test soon from a company at Callisto.fm. And if you sign up at Callisto.fm/beta, you too can be a part of that beta test. It integrates with your existing statistics measurements. It doesn't require any sort of special player, and it's going to be very, very cool. You can be a part of that test. Just go to Callisto.fm/beta, put in your email address, and make sure that you're included in the beta test for Callisto.fm.
Okay, back with David here at LifeStation. And David, this is a fantastic tool for home healthcare nurses. I, having been in that environment in the past, I can just tell you this is an amazing option for some of those patients. What's the price point on something like this?
Well, we run this on a subscription model. It's about $50 per month. And what's nice about that is by having essentially a lease model, it keeps the price down. There's no upfront cost for the equipment itself. We'll pay for shipping both ways, and there's no long-term agreement. Someone using this, a senior who needs this in their home, it's really a very easy decision because they can try it. If they don't like it, if they, you know, they're on the fence, I don't know if I need this, they can subscribe to this, and if after a month or two they say, you know, I really don't feel comfortable, all they have to do is call us and say, I don't want this anymore, and we'll take it back. As well, by maintaining a subscription service, if there's ever any kind of a problem with the equipment, we're able to troubleshoot, we're able to replace parts, and there's never a cost to the consumer. It makes it very simple.
Excellent. Now, is this available now?
Absolutely. We work primarily through the healthcare industry with a number of different channels, with hospitals, pharmacies, DME, HME suppliers, and both skilled and non-skilled home care agencies.
How about coverage through CMS or other payment service, third-party billers? Is this something that can be billed back to an insurance company?
At the moment, some of our services are covered through Medicaid. Medicare right now does not cover the service. There's a lot of talk right now that within the next couple of years, this is going to be available.
Do you have any, you're working on any research studies or anything like that to kind of give you some options on how is this improving compliance? Is that something you're looking at?
Absolutely. The designer did a test with the VA hospital in Brooklyn, New York, where they gave 250 patients the device to use for a set period of time. At the end of the test, the 125 of the patients, so 50%, uses as just a traditional pillbox. They did not have the alerts activated. 125 did. At the end of the test, the 125 they're using as a traditional pillbox had a compliance of around 50%, which is a little bit better than to be expected for someone just keeping their pills on the counter. Of the patients that were using this as with the alerts, notifying their caregivers, notifying them, letting them know when it was time to take their medication, their compliance was around 92%.
Wow, that's impressive. Well, this is a great tool, LifeStation. What's the website where people can find out some more information?
Well, our core business at LifeStation.com, and as well they can check out MedicationStation.com.
Very good. So we're going to go ahead and wrap up here. David, thank you very much. I'm Jamie Davis, the Pod Medic from the Nursing Show and the MedicCast, here with our friends at Tech Podcast Network covering CES 2012.
This is the Tech Podcast Network. If it's tech, it's here.